In our quest to discover how to become grand mentors God's way, we have been looking at my book called The Jesus Passages, seeking advice that Jesus would give to those of us who want to make an impact upon the generations of people that are coming behind us. Today, I'd like to talk to you about becoming a cheerleader, someone who celebrates the lives of those that are behind us so that by God's grace, they will go beyond themselves and do things that are greater. You know, in passage 2:29, Jesus talks about going home. He is talking to the disciples about his next step of going to the cross and dying and going to heaven. And in John chapter 4:14 and verse 12, he says, you know, I'm leaving and I've done all these things for you, but you will do greater things than these. He is telling the disciples that their ministry will be broader, will have a greater scope, they'll be able to touch more lives than even the Son of Man ever touched while he was on earth. How? Well, Jesus says, you'll have my words, you have the teaching I've given to you, but secondly, you're going to receive the Holy Spirit, who is going to empower you, who's going to guide you, who's going to remind you of everything that I have said, and he will take you into the world to truly make a difference for the kingdom of God. You know, I'll bet at that moment, those disciples did not think that there was any way that they could lose Jesus to a cross and still make a difference. They didn't feel the strength or the empowerment to be all that Jesus was telling them. And yet Jesus was on the sidelines cheering them on, helping them to cast a vision, to see something, a vision grander than themselves. You know, I believe all of us need a cheerleader in our lives. Who is out there complimenting, celebrating, thanking those you love, those coming behind you for the things that they are doing in their world? One of my old professors, Howard Hendricks, used to say that all people are born originals, but unfortunately, most die as copies. And the reason we don't rise to a new level of competence, the reason we don't boldly reach out and do things is maybe because we don't have someone encouraging us, being our cheerleader, helping us to go forward. You know, I look at my children, my grandchildren, those that are coming behind me. You know, in a negative sense, I'm what they've got as a father, as a grandfather. But in a positive sense, that's who I am. God sovereignly in heaven had the wisdom to place me in their lives, and he has confidence that I can cheer them on to become the people God wants them to be. Think about it. Who is in your family? Who in your network of friends, especially in the younger generation, that maybe are discouraged, maybe feel incompetent or unable? They need someone to come along and to cheer them on. Early in my ministry, I worked for a dear man who's become a good friend. And he used to jokingly, I thought jokingly, but I think he was serious, he would turn to people and said, you know, my friend Ron, my associate, he has more talent in his little finger than I have in my whole body. Now, I know that's not true. I think he probably knew that wasn't true. But what he wanted to do before other people and before me was to give me a confidence that God's hand was upon me and that God wanted to use me to do something very special. Today, I cherish him as a cheerleader. My mom spent 9 days in the hospital before she died. And on one of those gatherings, I was in the room alone with a lot of my children. And then we were around the bed and we had prayer with my mother and they all left and I was with her by myself. And I said, Mother, it's time for me to say goodnight. And she looked at me and she says, Ron, I love your family. And she says, Ron, I'm so proud of you. You know, that's something I will never forget because my mother was one of my greatest cheerleaders. My friends, there are people in your world who need you to celebrate them. They are running down the track of life and they're looking on the sidelines to see if someone is applauding, if someone is cheering for them to succeed, my friends, if you don't do it, who will?